Oh, hi David, sorry, I didn't get a lot of sleep last night. I must have dozed off there, sorry.
No worries, Science Sam, these are stressful times and I totally understand. It's hard to get to sleep these days.
And that's actually what I wanted to talk to you about, so I'm glad that you're here. How come, even at the best of times, a lot of people struggle getting to sleep, and even more so when they're stressed out?
Yeah, I approach this from the standpoint of an evolutionary biologist. So I think of this in terms of acute versus chronic stress. Acute stress is going to be that freeze, fight, or flight response that is going to upregulate your neuroendocrine system. It's going to boost norepinephrine to activate your body, and it's going to pop cortisol, so you have this eustress response. This is a positive stress response, gets you out of tricky situations. But it's a problem in a modern context when it doesn't dissipate, and we're triggered by so many things in our environment that causes chronic stress, ergo a failure of fear extinction, which might be adding to the problems that we have falling asleep at night.
Okay, so I'm hoping that there's still room for a good night's sleep in my near future. Any tips on how I can make that happen?
You want good sleep hygiene and you want good light hygiene. So sleep hygiene means that the environment that you're sleeping in is distraction-free. You don't want any big LCD screens in there blasting you with blue wave light, because blue wave light is bad. It's going to inhibit melatonin. Melatonin is the principal hormone that drives your sleep-wake regulation. So you want this to be an LCD light screen free environment. And you wanna have this routinized. So you wanna have your preparation about an hour before bed. You wanna go through the same ritual every night. And you even wanna eat around the same time every night, so your body internally knows when it's time to stop digestion and go into sleep. The second component of that is light hygiene. You wanna maximize your circadian rhythm by getting as much light as possible during the day. And when the sun goes down, you want to turn off as many lights as possible so that your body knows what time it is outside, and it's syncing your body for the best night's sleep you can possibly get.
But what if I do all of those things and sleep still doesn't come? What's going on?
So what I would definitely want to do is double down on the timing of your food when you consume. It should be negative 3 hours before you want to fall asleep, because your metabolism also runs on a circadian rhythm. So you have to understand circadian rhythms, I actually think, are even more important than what we think of as a good night's sleep, because your circadian rhythm is a much more evolutionarily ancient adaptation. You can go back to organisms that we shared a common ancestor with about, say, 500 million years, and they have circadian rhythms. So I think doubling down on enhancing and amplifying that circadian rhythm is absolutely critical.
This has been fascinating, and you've given me so many helpful tips to start incorporating. And I guess that's gonna start with shutting off all devices. So with that, thanks, David.
Sleep well.